Shall we get to the news? We don't have a lot of news this week, but let's get to it.
Good evening, Mr. Mission Office, South America, all the ships and clippers at sea. Let's go to France.
First bit of game news. Some people, Maddie, have been waiting for this for a long, long time. Xavier Georges is the designer of Trois, Maddie's number one game of all time. And his new game, Carnegie, we had some discussion as to whether or not, as to how you pronounce it. You definitely pronounce it Carnegie, the emphasis on the second syllable. Carnegie is going to be on Kickstarter January 18th. It is coming, ladies and gentlemen. The rules are not out yet. We've had some pictures. We've had some early reports. The early reports are very, very positive. It is going to be an economic engine building kind of game. And I would love to see what Xavier Georges is. You're a fan of Trois, aren't you?
Very much, yeah. Actually, I should have mentioned I am keeping up a game of Trois currently going as well. BGA has a fairly good build of it, and so it's happening. And yeah, I like Trois a lot, even though it can be a little bit messy, especially depending on who you're playing with. There's a lot of micro moves and a lot of things to take care of. It has that little bit of a cooperative aspect to it. I'm curious on Carnegie if they're going to, you know, total remix some elements of this. It is an amazing game. So Carnegie has a lot of things going for it already.
Indeed. Next up, I just want to keep people abreast of when some of the new hotness will be coming to the shores of America anyway. Hallertau, the new Uwe Rosenberg game a game that's been getting some mixed reviews in our particular group. Maddie is completely over the moon. Loves it. And I've got a couple other game brainers that say I don't think I need to play that game ever again. So I'm really dying to play it because everything I'm looking at about it, it looks like I might be on Maddie's side of the equation on this. It looks pretty amazing to me. We have found out now that on January 29th, it's going to be out in North America.
So soon.
I don't know how they're able to say for sure that data is going to hold, given what has happened to our post office, et cetera, but we'll take their word for it. And then a game that Jennifer has been talking about a little bit, Polynesia, is a game that she thinks very highly of. She's quite fascinated by it. I love the theme. I love the setting. And evidently, it is going to be in North America in stores on January 15th. So coming up really, really soon. Did you play? Go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say, do you think there's a rush for some of this because these developers, these publishers know that we're all going to be locked down for a little while longer and. Maybe these games that would have been held for some big fest or con now are just hey, we gotta ramp this up, put the gas on.
It's an interesting question because the truth of it is that both of those games, Polynesia and Hallertau, came out at Essen, and they would have if Essen happened, if the Spiel, if the fair had happened, they both would have been released there. And I believe that nowadays, when you release at Essen. But you are releasing to the States in December.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, get the holiday thing going right.
As best you can. It's actually a real scramble for a lot of publishers. They're really because the October date for the European debut and then meeting a shipping deadline to get it into stores fast enough for people to get it before Christmas is really super tight. I think in the future, Spiel may have to try and move back into September or something along those lines, or they may have to come up with another way to get that North American money. But realize that our hobby is an international one. It's not America centric, even if we are all Americans on this podcast. But yeah, I think that really, I think Polynesia and Hallertau would be a December release if not for COVID. So I think they're actually coming in late, is my guess. I don't know.
Well, welcome. Either way, I think our hobby does. There is a lot of banging our heads on the same games, especially the same online games. And so if there's some new hotness that can get people, feeling a slightly different way, especially if they devise some new mechanic that isn't quite as present in our current crop, would be great, right? I'm looking forward to that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I should also point out that there are some expansions that are quite interesting that are coming out. If you like Nusfjord, Matt talks often about how that's one of his favorite games, that sort of lost game. The year we were at Essen, it was the debut of Nusfjord, and we liked it very, very much. There's a salmon deck, new cards that are going to be for the expansion. That should be coming out pretty much right now. Wildlands, speaking of Martin Wallace's sort of lighter fantasy game, has an expansion called The Ancients. Two expansions for Anachrony that we've been waiting for quite some time are coming out as well. And there's even a new deck of cards for the new improved edition of Agricola called the Dulcinara deck.
Any chance we're going to have any game brainers on those cards? Just throwing it out there.
We do know that that there is a card that has Trey on it. But I don't think anybody is in this particular one. Who would you want to put on a card?
I mean, Dimitri, I think, if not already incidentally being honored in other podcasts, should be honored in other games. I'm just saying, especially for someone who probably would never actually play the game, probably the least interested in that, would be a fine fodder for such.
I agree. I think I also think that Jennifer, for her decades in the hobby, I think she should definitely have a card. The Pioneer, for instance, by the way, it wouldn't be the worst card in the world to have there. Next up in a piece of news, we have something that is going to make Maddie absolutely explode with joy. Concordia Solitaria is an expansion that allows single player game of Concordia, one of his favorite games, to be played. It is a special solo mode that you can do, and there'll be three skill levels: standard, advanced, and expert. Expert is supposed to be very, very hard to beat, I don't know. It looks really good. It should be only about 30 minutes to play it. And hey, if you are if you're isolated and you have Concordia Solitaria sounds like a no-brainer, right?
I mean, sure. Even though I can't even imagine how they're going to do this, how they're going to pull it off, but that's great.
Well, I mean, Matty did talk about how the Automas of the world have been really revolutionary in the hobby and not talked about very much, that people have come up with some amazing, amazing ways to take these multiplayer experiences and find a way to make them really engaging solo puzzles, which is...
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's really, really cool. I don't particularly like solo gaming particularly much, but I admire the design of it, and I love the fact that for people that do like it, that they're able to scratch that itch.
I just knew so little about it before solo mode episodes came along. I mean, thankfully, y'all had ushered me into the hobby so wonderfully, and so I never really had looked back into the idea of, you know, of, to me, solo gaming was, you know, those like choose your own adventures or stuff, which is a fine format, but really, you know, as a teenager or long ago, was not fleshed out. And so to hear the solo mode where things had gotten to the place that they were did make it really curious and interesting. I haven't pulled the lever on any of those in the kind of this COVID time, but I have been sorely really interested in possibly kicking up some of that stuff, but all based on the recommendations that Maddie's brought to the table. So, yeah, oh. Concordia Solitaria, right?
Solitaria, yes.
Solitaria, yeah. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's the one.
Maybe it is. One. And last but not least, there's a series of kind of, escape room games called Unlock. I have a couple of them. I played them. They're very elegant. It's a deck of cards, and the cards have hidden symbols and all sorts of things you have to figure out. You have to figure out how to use this card to get to that card, and to you. Sometimes the cards are clues that are on the table in front of you when you're putting things together. Very, very creative. Very, very well done as far as a short escape room experience. Well, Unlock now has a kids version that is going to be a brand for younger kids. There are going to be puzzles and adventures, and they're going to be aimed at kids ages 6 and up. So not quite for you yet, Alfred, but it's...
I wonder if Jesse's kids, I'd imagine Jesse,
yes,
who I've known as being an escape room enthusiast,
yes,
and done even a handful with them.
Owner.
And then...
But
then
room.
equally, like, I imagine this kind of game really scratches some of their itches, and then their kids are kind of they're a little older than that, right? But
Yeah.
something like that, they're around that age.
Yeah,
Gosh,
I think
that
they
seems built for it.
might be dead on. Now with your baby, you're mostly playing Panzerblitz, is that right?
I mean, my baby seems to be mostly interested in the game of discovering their hands right now, just a little bit. Like, I have hands. That's a game, right? That's a dexterity game, really. It's a
It's a
pretty advanced
really good
dexterity
game.
game, and I'm really in awe.
Yeah.
Also, What is a Smile, which again is a lovely game to see unfold. It's really an experiential multiplayer game that is also has a solo variant, but
Well, and
so.
the adult mirror to that, as they're doing that game, you're playing Smile or Fart, where you're trying to figure out whether or not the smile means they have a lot of gas or
There's definitely a lot of gas going on, but most of it's just evident. I don't know about secret gas yet. That's a different that's there's the traitor mechanic game kicking up again. But there has been a lot of guessing to see if the blue stripe has shown up on the diaper right now. We are using mostly cloth diapers, just FYI, but the occasional disposable becomes a whole different game. So
Yes, we
escape room styles, but escape the diapers.
totally we did cloth for both of our kids, and we were very happy with how that
Great.
turned out. It was certainly more work, certainly a little more effort, but we felt it was important, and we felt it was worth it. And the kids were happier, you know. They needed a change, and boom, hey, change me, right? Don't let me sit in this. So, I thought it was pretty great.
Absolutely.
That's it for the news. That's all we got.
Hey, if you enjoyed that video, you very well might enjoy the other videos you now see being suggested to you on screen. Also, we'd greatly appreciate it if you could like, share, or subscribe to our Game Brain channel. Thanks so much.